and welcome to my talk. I am Katharina Anders and I will be presenting our research about time series based surface change analysis. The objective of our approach is to extract surface changes from high frequency 3D time series. We can acquire point clouds, for example, at hourly intervals over long periods by permanent terrestrial laser scanning to extract the spatial and temporal surface dynamics of a natural scene. With increasingly long and dense 3D time series, a large range of changes with different magnitude, spatial extent, duration, and change rates may occur in an observed scene. And the challenge for current methods is to automatically extract these changes without a priori information when and where they occur and what their properties are. When using the standard approach of b-temporal surface change analysis between pairs of epochs, it is required to select analysis periods, and this can lead to successive changes being aggregated or completely missed if the periods are too long. Think of the complex morphodynamics of a beach where sand may slowly accumulate over several days and then be transported away during some stormy period. And accumulation or erosion forms may also spatially overlap, and it is then difficult to separate them in b-temporal change quantification. This is why we developed a method that makes use of the surface change history to detect and spatially delineate changes from 3D time series. So our method of spatial-temporal segmentation first detects changes in the temporal domain of surface changes at a location in the scene. And this location and detected period is used as seed for spatial region growing regarding neighboring locations with a similar surface change history in the detected period. And the resulting segment provides what we call a 4D object by change, which was identified based on its surface change history. The use case for our method is permanent laser scanning and coastal monitoring, where a laser scanner was mounted on a hotel roof to scan the underlying beach scene at hourly intervals, in our case, over several months. So surface change between point clouds contains, for example, the formation of sandbars here or the removal and deposition of sand through anthropogenic works. As input for our method, we calculate point cloud distances using the M3C2 algorithm for each epoch to the first epoch as global reference. This is done at locations in a regular grid and thereby creates a 3D array of surface changes with 1D time series at each 2D location in the scene. And this space time array is the input for spatial temporal segmentation to automatically extract 4D objects by change. In this automatic workflow, the seed detection is first run at all locations in the scene, then the seed list is sorted, and region growing of segments regarding time series similarity starts. The segmentation continues until no more seed candidates are available, which have not been already segmented into a previous object. For the 3D time series of the sandy beach, more than 2,040 objects by change were extracted. The maps here show three change forms that illustrate how drawbacks of pairwise change analysis are avoided. The two accumulation forms occur in the same area, but in successive periods and are separately extracted. And the erosion and accumulation form over here occur during the same period and are independently delineated with some spatial overlap at the boundaries. Now let me come to the disadvantage of the time series based method, which is the increase in computational cost introduced by the region growing, where time series similarity is calculated for each search location. The similarity metric is derived as fast dynamic time warping distance, which has a linear complexity. And we therefore examined if the temporal or the spatial resolution can be reduced, at least for some of the changes, to achieve a reduction in overall runtimes. For this, we selected 12 4D objects by change extracted from the beach time series that have different change properties and analyzed the influence of reduced data resolutions on the resulting spatial extent compared to the highest resolution as reference. This assessment shows no direct link to the change properties of magnitude and duration, as you can see up here, but we could still identify groups of similar performance for reduced resolutions where some segment extent achieved acceptable performance with fluctuating deviation of the spatial extent. But for example, down here, one group of change forms performed extremely poorly with, as you can see here, extreme deviations in spatial extent to the reference. And this is the case, particularly when the temporal subsampling removes the distinctiveness of the surface change history, as in this example. And then the region growing is not constrained to the detected change anymore, and the spatial extent, as you can see here, when decreasing the temporal resolution to 24 hours, is 10 times larger. What do we take from this? For future applications, we may make use of a more intelligent subsampling of the data per detected change, which then would allow to more efficiently perform spatial-temporal segmentation. The overall decrease in performance using reduced data resolutions may be acceptable in the first part of many change analyses to detect changes and more coarsely delineate them for subsequent detail analysis. Thereby, our time series-based method poses an important approach to change analysis from 3D time series to detect and extract the large variety of surface changes that can potentially be observed in natural scenes. So thank you very much for following this talk, and please refer to our paper and related publications for more information.